Ladies and gentlemen, Brahma Kumaris Malaysian family is honored to have your presence for today's program, which is jointly organized with Indian High Commission Malaysia to celebrate the special occasion of the UN International Day of Yoga, which is observed every year on 21st June since 2015, following its inception in the United Nations General Assembly in September 2014. Yoga is a physical, mental, and spiritual practice that originated in India and is helping people lead a healthier lifestyle. The International Yoga Day is a gift of India to the world, and the idea to mark the summer solstice, the longest day in the Northern Hemisphere, has a special significance, as it is believed that on this day, the Supreme Father had imparted the knowledge of yoga to the world. Yoga for well-being, the theme for International Yoga Day 2021, has never been more relevant, especially when the mental and physical health of individuals has come under dire stress during this pandemic. Scientific research have proven that yoga can help reduce stress levels, increase awareness, build immunity, and strong physical and mental health. We have an interesting lineup of sharing today, and to formally begin the program, let me call upon the president of Brahma Kumaris Malaysia, Dato Lachmanan Brahmada, the retired Director General of Biosafety at the Ministry of Natural Resources and Environment Malaysia, who surrendered his life on spiritual service 4 decades ago and took the role of leading the organization in the year 1991 due to his exemplary capability of committed and well-balanced personality. Ladies and gentlemen, Dato Lachmanan for the welcome address.
Thank you. Your Excellency Sri Mridur Kumar, Indian High Commissioner to Malaysia, BK Rajayogini Meera Nagananda, BK Rajayogini Sudatta Ratti, brothers and sisters, welcome to the celebration of the United Nations International Yoga Day on the theme Reemerge, Reawaken, Reunite with Your Authentic Self. Om Shanti to, and welcome to the celebration of United Nations International Yoga, organized by Brahma Kumaris Malaysia and supported by the Indian High Commission. Today, the world is going through full of uncertainties. This COVID pandemic has shaken the world so much that so many people are disturbed by this, so many people have died, and many more people are in critical conditions. People are full of sorrow, thinking about the current situation and the future. But what solution do we see? Can we really solve this problem? At personal level, it is possible that if we can take care the health of our body so that the immune power of the body is maintained at a high level, is possible. So exercises, and this is where the yoga exercise also becomes a very important instrument for people to build their immune power. Apart from that, people also can increase their immune power by choosing to eat food that can build immunity. Traditionally also, we have food items that has high immunity, but today we have to consciously eat these items so that our body can remain strong. But the main thing is, whatever we do, the problem is people nowadays are quite careless nature. That they don't like to be taught by others. They don't like to be given advice or directives by others to do this or that, which they have not been doing it for a long time. Sometimes they think that nothing is happening or nothing will happen to them. So our society actually reluctantly want to really be serious about it. This is a great defect in the world over. Our value systems and spirituality is gradually breaking away and exposing us to danger. So how can we improve this? One method that we all know that our mind can influence our body. So if we can strengthen our mind, you know, if we can create positive thoughts in whatever situation, whatever problems that we are going through, then that positive vibrations will affect all the cells of the body. And not only you are taking care of the health of the body through your exercise, but now by practicing positive thoughts, you are creating positive vibrations. So it's a time to create a revolution of practicing positive culture. At the moment, we are actually on the path of destroying ourselves by not knowing how to be constantly positive. You know, sometimes we are affected by our own arrogance, and then we don't want to accept the truth. The truth is, we are serious matters are happening, but our understanding is that what does it matter? I'll be okay. The careless attitude, this one. And then on the mental level, people do get disturbed. For example, if somebody come and points at your weaknesses, will you be able to accept it in a calm way? Most people cannot. You know, most people do not like others to point at their weaknesses. Sometimes even if they mention in a nice way, because today people, they are not prepared to accept any comments. So when we say we talk too much about somebody's weakness, then that person internally get very irritated. And he will keep thinking about it. It's not that after somebody has mentioned he's going to forget, he's going to keep thinking about it. And so when he keeps thinking negative things, then he's spoiling himself, he's spreading negative vibrations. So therefore the body is also going to be affected. This is where we should learn meditation, because meditation gives us the power to change our thoughts in 1 second from negative to positive by just making the right decision, that is giving the command that, no, whatever people tell about me, I want to take it positive and remain positive. People can say whatever they say, I know about myself, and maintain that positive power. So like this, we in Raj Yoga are teaching meditation, easy meditation, and then help us to build positive power and help us also in curing diseases. On the short note, I hope all of you will will develop interest to learn this meditation and take benefit from it. And hope you will also enjoy this program and pick up some useful things for your life. Thank you so much. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Brother Lachu, for that enlightening start to the evening. Ladies and gentlemen, we are honored and deeply humbled as the Indian High Commissioner in Malaysia, His Excellency, Sri Mridul Kumar Ji, had agreed to jointly organize this session with Brahma Kumaris Malaysia. Now, I would like to request His Excellency for his special opening address to commemorate this occasion.
A very good day to everyone. The head of Brahma Kumaris in Malaysia, Sister Meera, Dato Lashman, Sister Bhajo, it's indeed a great honor and a privilege to join Brahma Kumaris Malaysia for this virtual celebrations of the International Day of Yoga 2021. I bring greetings from the Indian High Commission in Kuala Lumpur on this very wonderful day. You would all recall that it was 2015 that United Nations, with a very large majority and in fact total consensus of its member countries, decided to celebrate and mark 21st June as the International Day of Yoga. And since then, the world community, in the leadership of India and our Honorable Prime Minister, Shri Narendra Modi, as also the efforts of the Ministry of Ayush and the Indian Cultural Center in Kuala Lumpur, as also the Indian Council of Cultural Relations in New Delhi, have been working closely to celebrate this occasion every year. We have seen an enormous increase in the popularity of yoga since 21st June was declared as the International Day of Yoga by the United Nations. In Kuala Lumpur, we have witnessed that the number of people who have joined our celebrations, both physically before the COVID pandemic hit us in 2020, as also after that, when we started doing these celebrations in a virtual mode, the number of participants have increased by leaps and bounds. In 2019, we had about 15,000 people who physically attended various events organized by the Indian High Commission in partnership with like-minded organizations like Brahma Kumaris. Last year, we had very good virtual celebrations where Brahma Kumaris led some of the celebrations. This year again, because of the pandemic situation, we have brought yoga home. We want yoga enthusiasts in Malaysia to do yoga on a very special theme: be with yoga, be at home. And I exhort the yoga lovers in Malaysia to do these exercises not only for their own physical well-being, but also for their mental peace, also for their spiritual upliftment. As we can see, the kind of extraordinary work that Brahma Kumaris Malaysia is doing in this direction, this is a step forward and an additionality of effort to do the same thing for people's upliftment, especially in such difficult times when the world is needing a healing touch. And this healing touch is brought about by the efforts of spiritual organizations like Brahma Kumaris. I want to thank Sister Meera, her organization, and everybody associated with Brahma Kumaris Malaysia to do the International Day of Yoga in conjunction with the Indian High Commission And I also want to thank them personally for their continued efforts in bringing about greater awareness of yoga. With these words, I thank once again Brahma Kumaris Malaysia for inviting me for these virtual celebrations. I wish all the yoga lovers and yoga enthusiasts, both in Malaysia and in India, a very, very happy International Day of Yoga. May Lord fill us all our lives, with peace, with happiness, and with abundant health. May we all get a healing touch of the Almighty that is so much needed in these times of difficulty. I thank you. God bless.
We are truly thankful to Sri Mridul Kumarji, who has been a strong believer of yoga and has been supporting Brahma Kumaris in various initiatives. Sir, we thank you and your team for this opening address. Talking about yoga will be incomplete if there's no demonstration. Moving next, we have few simple exercises demonstrated by Sister Amy that can be easily practiced at home. Brahma Kumari Amy Lee, the owner of Amy Yoga Studio, is a full-time Raja Yogini who has been a yoga instructor for a decade and an aromatherapy practitioner. Ladies and gentlemen, please get ready on your seats for these exercises.
Om Shanti, brother and sister, Namaste. As we all know that yoga means the union or connection between two entities. In Raja Yoga, we experience the union between we soul and our beloved Supreme Soul. Now, we are going to do physical yoga in order to have an experience of our inner body. First, I would like to introduce the three major nadis in our body. So the first nadi is Sushumna. This is the main tube along our backbone, and also all the seven chakras are situated at the column of our backbone. So when this tube is straight and smooth, the energy, the chi is flowing smoothly in this tube. So the second and the third nadi I'm going to introduce to you is the Ida and Pingara nadis. So these two nadi are situated at the side of this main tube, Sushumna. If we have emotional feeling due to our vices, these two nadi will become tightened, and because there is an intercrossing of this nadi with the chakra. So whenever it become tightened, it will choke the air inside the Sushumna, so the air cannot flow smooth. And this time what we feel is we become more emotional. And during our yoga practice, we can feel the pulling of our body. So Om Shanti, brother and sister, let us start to do some physical yoga to untangle these two nadi. Om Shanti. So first, what we are going to do is we have to use inhaling and exhaling to feel the tension and to release the pull. So first, lift your leg up. Inhale, pull in, lift your toes in, and hold your, tense your whole body. Inhale, hold it, One, two, three, exhale. Release. One more time. Inhale. Hold it. One, two, three, four, exhale. One more time. Inhale. Hold it. One, two, three, four, exhale. Okay, now we are going to do our head. Inhale. Center is your nose. Exhale. Turn your head to the side. Inhale. Feel the tension at the side. Exhale. Relax. Inhale. One more time. Exhale. Slowly bring your head back to the center. Remember your nose as a center point. Exhale to the side. Inhale. Feel the pull at the side of your neck. Exhale. Inhale again. Exhale. One more time. Bring your head back to the center. Now we are going to use our chin as the center. Inhale and exhale. Can feel even more pull at the side. Inhale, exhale. One more time. Exhale. Inhale, bring your head back to the center. Chin as the center to the other side. Inhale and exhale. You can even hold this pose for 3 minutes. Inhale, exhale. Inhale, bring your head to the center. Concentrate on your chin. Inhale, bring your chin up and bring down. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Your chin up. Lift it up all the way up to the ceiling. Relax your shoulder and your neck. Exhale. Inhale, exhale, one more time, exhale, inhale, bring your head back to the center, and exhale. So now we are going to pull our nadi as this side, put your palm here, inhale. And exhale. Inhale. Exhale. One more time. Exhale. Inhale. Back to the center. And exhale. We are going to do the other side. Inhale. And exhale. Inhale and exhale. Inhale, exhale. Inhale back to the center and exhale. So we're going to open up our chest and our back. So Om Shanti. Inhale up. Open our head, open up our chest, open up our back and your palms, slightly holding your neck. Look a little bit up, holding your neck longer. Inhale, exhale. Open up your shoulder blade. Inhale, exhale. Relax your neck. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. So we are going to do our lower back. We are going to twist in to side by side. So if we are sitting on the floor, then you can do it this way. By doing this, before or after meditation, you can do this way on the floor. Or if you are sitting on a chair, then you can do this. Open up your hand and over. All in your chair, inhale. Exhale, turn to the back. Inhale, hold it here. Exhale. One more time. And the last one.
Thank you, Sister Amy, for those simple exercising tips. Now, sitting on a chair for long hours won't feel torturous. Truly energizing. Thank you so much. This evening, brothers and sisters, we have a special guest who joins us from India to share about the holistic benefits of yoga. I'm talking about Rajyogini Sujata Rathi, a first-class honors graduate from Pune University, an author of a vegetarian cookbook based on fitness principles called Divine Vegetarian Delicacies, a certified health, dietetics, and nutrition expert, a professional fitness advisor and trainer who coordinates various lifestyle and wellness programs at Global Hospital and Research Center in Mount Abu, Rajasthan, India. Ladies and gentlemen, please join me in welcoming BK Sujata. Om Shanti.
Om Shanti. Very warm greetings from Madhuban and the Holy Mountain. And especially many, many congratulations to the respected our High Commissioner, respected our Didi Meera, and the entire team and the Malaysian family. Happy International Yoga Day. So it's very interesting that nowadays you can show or you can celebrate yoga on Zoom also. So congratulations to everyone. And because we don't want any gap with any pandemic situation even, right? It's a very nice topic actually, the health benefits of yoga. Actually, when the health comes front of us and when we utter the word health, so definitely we are just thinking the health like physical health. And you know, it's a very certain connection. Before physical health is mental health, right? And yoga is a word actually, this is united of all the types of health. And that's how we say it's a life journey. So it's spiritual health, mental health, social health, and physical health. So definitely today, the time allows us for the slot given me. So definitely I am going to share with you different kinds of yoga benefits in a demonstration way. So first, as we talk about the benefits, of course, everyone wants to be benefited in any situation and any kind of health. So first benefit of yoga is security. It's a mental security, because when you are healthy, there is no fear. You have a stamina to face any situation comes front of you, any situations, no matter it might be different elements, different situations, and mental health, like your confidence. Some people have a inferiority complexes, yes. So, but exercise benefits of yoga is bring discipline in you. That's the very important benefit we are getting from the holistic yoga. Actually, holistic yoga, you know, it's a very ancient, from the ancient time. Okay, I'm from India. And you are in Malaysia, right? But the first, I would say, the benefit of yoga, it starts from the Om. And you know, like Om is a first sound of universe. So we start our health to increase our immunity, to get a positive aura around us with the Om. Yeah. So I wanted you to sit straight like a king. Yeah. How the person sits smartly, gracefully. And we are going to chant Om. Yeah. 5 times. And this is one of the very important benefit, because like we understand ourselves through the Om chanting. So I wanted to, you sit, my all dear friends, thumb and index finger together, thumb and index finger together, and place at your right hand, left side of the knee, your spine straight, your abdomen straight, and now take a deep breath and Om sound we are going to perform. Sit relax, your face relax, your neck relax, your shoulder relax. And take a deep breath. An Om sound. Just finish this Om chanting. That's how you start your day. When you wake up in the morning, first thing we always say gratitude to the Almighty, to the God, to Almighty. So how you will gratitude? It's a health benefit. It increases the immunity system. It is very good for your back, it is very good for as nurture to our mental state, and as we are creating positive aura, because vibration also does. The vibration actually brings the positivity in you, and as you spread the positivity around us, that's the great benefit of yoga. And even in yoga poses or the exercise, whatever you do, exercise, any form of exercise, any type of yoga, correct? Because sometimes nowadays, people have the combination also. Yoga and the different stretchings together. That is, we call it a power yoga. So we'll do some power yoga as well. So first, I wanted you to sit straight. Now lift your right leg. Screen aayega aage. Now, see, I'm sitting, you are sitting on the chair, correct? You are sitting on the chair, I'm sitting on the chair. And see how we can do some yoga posture, which is benefit for our leg or lower body. See the right leg. Yeah. And just stretch. Stretch your right foot towards to you. Yeah, stretch. And the right hand straight up. Right hand straight up. Now inhale and exhale. Inhale and exhale. Touch your chin to the chest. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. See, what we are going to perform or what we are doing, we are just stretching. We are stretching our body in a secure way, right? Because sometimes the knee problem happens, joint pain happens, but yoga postures actually make the good effect, positive effect in our pain. So now the left leg straight, and stretch your left foot. Now your right hand straight at the ear level, right? At the ear level, and now inhale and exhale, touch your chin to the chest. Your spine straight, back straight. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. And now, both hand at the back. Both hand at the back. See, sometimes the acidity, the food reflux, the acid reflux. So there's a heartburn. Yeah. So this exercise is take out the shoulder pain of the shoulder, and it is beneficial who are suffering from the acidity. So both hand, relax both hand. At the back. Now inhale and exhale. See up. Inhale and exhale. See up. You correct your posture again. You roll on your shoulder. Roll on your shoulder. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Correct? Now inhale and exhale. Touch your chin to the chest. And this is very good for your whole spine and back. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Now, I wanted you to stand straight. Stand straight. And now, we are going to perform some exercise in a standing posture. Because today, again, on an International Yoga Day, we are knowing about the benefits. It's not only benefit, but the holistic benefit. Yeah. So such a simple body postures how you can enjoy and how you can get benefit from the get rid of from the pain. So now right hand straight. In this posture, we are going to do some movement which is beneficial for the frozen shoulder. And now right palm stretch, right palm stretch. As you stretch and again at the right side of the shoulder level. Now in this stretch, inhale, exhale, and your face towards to your right hand. Stretch, 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 and relax. Okay, so now next is left hand stretch, left palm stretch. Yeah, now in this posture, we are going to do inhale and exhale. Move your neck, your right side opposite of your left hand. Stretch, stretch. Move your neck properly, your upper body straight, only hand movement at the same left side of the shoulder level. Nicely give a nice stretch and again relax. Very good. So now both hand at your back and just lift your heels. Just lift your heels. And now roll on your feet, toes and heel up and down, and get rid of from the backache. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and swing your hand. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Yes. Now both hand at your right and left side of the shoulder level. And again, lift your heels. So this is, you can get rid of from the heel pain, on your knee pain, lower back. 2, 3, 4, and 5. So now we are in a standing posture. And you know, there is a yoga, laughing yoga. So for sure, today is International Yoga Day. And you know, because of the pandemic and because of the different situation, some people actually they forgot to laugh, to smile, to be like, how it can help the laughing yoga to increase our immune system, right? And the yoga, what we do every day, it really connects immediately in just a few seconds to connect to the Almighty, yeah? Because all our nervous system, our endorphin hormone releases, our nervous system is also getting very calm and soothing. And then we can connect to the positive source like Almighty, and we get the benefit from our Master Almighty, the positivity in our self, and get the strength. Okay, so ready for laughing yoga? Yes, sister Pinna? Yes, so there are 3 ways of laughing yoga. Okay, after laughing yoga, we are going to do angelic smile as well, right? Okay, so everyone in a standing posture. First laugh is laugh from the navel, yeah? The second is, I will show you second afterward, but we are going to perform all together. 1, 2, 3, and start. Ha 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 good strength, yeah? And the second laughing yoga is, as the exercise, you both leap together, yeah? And then you laugh without showing your, okay, ready? You can make a fist and then you might have a thought of that, how this laughing yoga is beneficial. You know, this the second yoga, laughing, what we did, it's very good for our core muscles. Yeah, it's very good for our good bacteria. And of course, it is good for the immunity. And the research and what we have did the research in our place, it's very good for to take out the anxiety, take out the depression, take out the loneliness, take out the negativity within, and to change your attitude towards the positive life, progressive life. And what we have seen, the results, what there is, medicine is not working, but that's how we say laughter is the best medicine. So third yoga, third laughing is like sometimes we have pain, like children has a pain, but they can't talk, right? They don't know the which language they should use. So third yoga is open your jaw and no sound, correct? That's, we are going to laugh, but no sound. Ready? One, two, three, and start. Very good. So this third laughing yoga, its benefits, actually, it little bit goes the high rate, little bit heart rate is up. The laughing yoga is wrinkle free, yeah? Because all the muscles of the jaw, it is very good for our throat, for your vocal cord. And of course, it cleans the respiratory tract. So it's very good for the lungs, very good for to increase our immunity system. Now next we are going to do angelic smile. So both hand together. You know this posture, actually when we say namaste, as sister said, namaste, and when we, this is the position of the prayer pose. This is good for the, as the benefit of yoga is heart massage. It's a massage for the heart, right? Because all this is a our acupressure points in our both palm, right? So we say it is a switchboard of the body. And when we bring 10 fingers together, palm together, and we actually make pose of the namaste. And it's a beautiful, like you should have a angelic smile on your face. Just breathe in and breathe out. Inhale and exhale through the nose. and we are saying, I'm a happiest person, I'm a safest person, I'm safe, I'm going to keep safe others, because Almighty is with us. All the strength I'm getting from my beloved father, and you know, today's a Father's Day. So we are gratitude bottom of our heart to our beloved father. Thank you. Thank you. And thank you, my beloved father. And we say Om Shanti. Means I'm a peaceful soul, but peaceful and graceful, both. Yes? Yes. So now next yoga, we are going to do tapping. Here, yeah? Tapping exercise. So is it okay? We can do some tapping exercise as a, to boost your metabolism, because I think everyone is there, and we can do just a 3-minute tapping yoga, tapping exercises, which is to boost our metabolism, right? So I wanted you to stand straight and just steps, correct? Because when we teach yoga, it's not only the yoga. There is a different movements, yeah? Slow yoga, then medium, then high impact yoga, sports yoga, advanced yoga. And the main foundation is the how the endorphin releases in our body. Endorphin means what? It's a happy hormone, right? Happy hormone. As the hormone happy hormone is released, so we feel very happy and positive, and that's how we connect to the fantastic meditation, right? So the steps, and with your hand up and down, smiling on your face, and just have a thought, I'm a healthy person, I'm mentally healthy, physically fit, and my beloved father is with me as a spiritual part, and I want to keep my entire society, my family in a good shape, healthier way. Shake your hand. Good. Very good. I can see sister is doing, sitting on a chair and shaking her hand. You can boost yourself 3 minutes, 5 minutes in a day. Good for digestion and good for your stomach problem, good for your diabetes. It activates the pancreas. So both hands tap on the abdominal part, gentle, gentle tapping. Because whatever we do in our daily routine, we should be very happy, and we should think that we are constructing this moment, yeah? So why can't happy moment? And now both hands together, right and left side. Good, very good. Well done. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. And now clapping. Clap of your this part, right? Clap for pure is calm. And just take the pull of energy, because you are what you can. Yes. And clap. Right and left. Right and left. Right and left. So all the joints, all the lactic acid, whatever is accumulated in your body, just take out from this. Very good, very good. And now next is, the important is appreciate yourself, right? So right hand on your left side of the shoulder level, and appreciate yourself respectfully and gracefully. Come on, right. Take your upper body. Appreciate yourself. Thank you, thank you, thank you, my beloved father. Today we are celebrating Father's Day and the International Yoga Day together. Appreciate yourself. And now, other side, your left. Yourself, your body right to left and left to right. Eight, nine, and ten. Now you can sit on chair. Sit nicely, sit gracefully. And how we can recharge, how we can use our brain, make the synchronization in our body, upper body, lower body. You know, the benefits of the yoga is what we have seen, to take the right kind of decision at the right time. That comes from the how you are practicing every day. Yes, it's not like that. When you are in the trouble, when you are in the pain, and you will start. No, don't do that. Respect yourself. That I think we should all take the pledge today. Today is today. Yeah, 20th June won't come tomorrow, because tomorrow is 21st June. So today is today, and today is, so today is the time of 20th June. Today we all are going to take the pledge. I am going to do the holistic yoga every day. Physical yoga as well as meditation to connect with the Almighty. So my all the very best wishes from everyone for the all types of health. Om Shanti, Namaste.
Thank you, Sister Sujata. That was really insightful and energizing. Yes, indeed. Physical health is directly dependent on mental health. As you rightly mentioned, there's no second thought about the universal sound of Om, as it purifies every cell of the body and our core. We thank you for joining us tonight and sharing valuable yogic tips and making us spiritually, respectfully graceful. Thank you so much. Up next, we have Raj Yogini Meera Nagananda, the director of Brahma Kumaris Malaysia, a science graduate who surrendered her life in spiritual service in the year 1968. And since then, has traveled across the globe, sharing the secrets of meditation that she has extensively researched on. Today, she talks about healing body, mind, and spirit through ancient Raj Yoga. Let us hear Sister Meera.
Om Shanti. His Excellency, the Indian High Commissioner to Malaysia, Mr. Mridul Kumar, Brother Lachu, President of Brahma Kumaris Malaysia, Sister Sujata, nutritionist from the Global Hospital, India, Mount Abu, brothers and sisters. First of all, I would like to extend greetings for the International Day of Yoga Celebration 2021. This year, International Day of Yoga is quite unique because the pandemic has had a very profound impact on our psychological and spiritual being, which has actually awakened quite a few dormant internal aspects in our life. And people have started to think about the meaning of life, the purpose of life, and what directions to take for the future. And I am sure this situation has given an opportunity for all of us to rethink about directing our life energy in a positive way to prepare ourselves to face the future challenges. And yoga, as we all know, is a very old word we have been using for ages, since Vedic times. And definitely practicing yoga brings a lot of energy into our life, physical and spiritual, that could help us in many areas. The word yoga actually comes from the Sanskrit word yuj, which means link, or yoga can be practiced physical or hatha yoga exercises and asks to keep the body healthy and fit. And the other type of yoga is spiritual yoga or mental yoga, that is practiced to keep our body and spirit healthy. And I believe that we need both kinds of yoga according to the present time, because we begin to realize that what happens to the body affects our mind, and what happens to our mind has a deep impact on our body. Because we human beings are made up of two types of energies, body and soul, physical and spiritual aspect. What I am going to share with you today is about how ancient Raja Yoga helps to heal body, mind and spirit. Yoga can be practiced. Spiritual yoga can be practiced in 7 ways. It can be practiced as karma yoga, yoga of action, bhakti yoga, yoga of devotion, jnana yoga, yoga of knowledge, buddhi yoga, yoga of intellect, samatva yoga, yoga of balance, and sampurna yoga, yoga of perfection. And so when we are able to practice all these kinds of yogas together, it will definitely help us to create a balance between the body and the spirit. And I believe that the ancient Raja Yoga is the all-encompassing yoga that will automatically make us the king, the master. And that is why it is called Raja Yoga. So when I practice Raja Yoga in my life, all the other 7 types of yoga are included in it. And so I'm going to share with you today how ancient Raja Yoga helps us to heal the body and the spirit, the soul. Raja means king. Raja also means master. So when I am able to master my thoughts, when I am able to master my mind, I am able to direct the power of my mind in a positive way. And directing my mind in a positive way will definitely help to create inner harmony, inner unity, and that enhances our immune system, and that will automatically create balance in our body also. Raja Yoga can be practiced on 3 levels. There are 3 steps to practice Raja Yoga. First is to to turn my mind within, that is called inner journey. Second step is outer journey, journey outwards, and then finally journey upwards. You know, whenever we talk about yoga and meditation, people tend to separate them. In fact, we understand very clearly that meditation and yoga are not 2 different things. You begin with meditation and you finish with yoga, because meditation comes from the word mediri, which means to heal. So when I begin to create a positive pattern of thoughts in my mind, I begin to actually heal my mind first of all, heal my heart, and that healing has such a deep impact that it goes to other systems of the body. So we begin with meditation, that is contemplation, and then we go into concentration, and finally into realization. So all that I need to understand in order to go into this yoga practice is to know myself, who am I, know my relationship with God, and thirdly, very important aspect, where I have come from and where I have to go. Once I am able to search answers for these 3 main questions, I can begin my journey and I can begin to experience the benefit of Raja Yoga meditation. So I think, you know, this is a very important question we need to ask ourselves before we practice Raja Yoga to heal the body and the spirit, is who am I? When you introduce yourself to others, what are the things you talk about yourself? Maybe you talk about your name, your position, your occupation, but that is your identity. But who are you? So when I begin to realize that I am not this body, this is the body is my instrument, I am a soul, a living energy within this body, which has mind, intellect, and sanskaras. So I am a soul with mind, intellect, and sanskaras. I am immortal, I am eternal. As it is said in Bhagavad Gita, the soul can never be burnt, it can never be drowned, and it can never die. So I am that eternal soul, and my nature as a soul is peace and love. So the moment I begin to meditate, I become aware of this aspect of who am I, and I begin to feel the peace, I begin to feel the love, which is my nature. And then slowly I am able to connect myself with the Supreme, who is the Creator. So just as I, the soul, I am a point of light, the Supreme, the Creator, is also a being of light. But of course, the intensity of the Supreme is much more than what I am. So through the yoga of intellect, I connect myself with the Supreme, and then I am able to lift my consciousness beyond this gross world into another region of light, which we call Brahmanda or seventh heaven or the highest heaven, in whichever language you want to call it. And so when I'm able to connect as a soul with the Supreme in my home, that is when I am in yoga with God. So that is the time I begin to experience the benefits of Raja Yoga meditation. Raja Yoga has several benefits: physical, mental, psychological, and physiological benefits. And that is why we really encourage people to practice Raja Yoga meditation at least twice a day, morning and evening, to prepare themselves to face challenges in life. Because Raja Yoga meditation definitely increases your self-confidence. Raja Yoga meditation helps you to develop your self-respect, makes you more fearless, and it will give you the power to face challenges in your life. More than that, even if you are experiencing any physical ailments, you are able to cope with them because your coping ability increases, your immune system improves, and so you are able to combat the disease easily and heal yourself. This is what we have found, that those who practice Raja Yoga meditation, the doses of medicine they have to take is much lesser than others, and the healing process, the curing time becomes lesser, because the attitude, the state of mind with which they deal with the situation becomes positive. And together with that, of course, you know, we also have a physiological benefit, in the sense that many people are suffering from insomnia, sleeping sickness, emotional imbalance. It is because of not knowing the spirit, how to handle emotions. And so Raja Yoga meditation also helps us in the sleeping disorders. It also helps in creating emotional imbalance. And so this Raja Yoga meditation can be practiced by anyone at any time. There is no time restriction, age restriction. It doesn't involve any rituals and ceremonies. It can be practiced anywhere by anyone of any age. I was thinking that, you know, according to the theme, this year for the International Yoga Day, yoga at home, yoga with the family, I think Raj Yoga fits there very nicely. All that you need to do is you just need to make a quiet place in your home and all the family members sit together at least maybe once a day and meditate together. You know, connect yourself with the Supreme and draw that positive energy into yourself so that first of all, you are able to bring peace of mind in your personal life. You know, when each member of the family have peace in their mind, naturally the home will be filled with peace. And when your home is filled with peace with the practice of Raj Yoga, the vibrations of that peace will automatically reach the neighbors and then from there to the street, and it will spread slowly everywhere. And I would encourage that, you know, not only on the International Yoga Day, but make it like a habit, you know, to wake up every morning with a one positive thought. If possible, in the morning, if the family members can sit together and meditate, if not, at least evening. Because the best time for Raj Yoga meditation is before sunrise or after sunset. And so even if you can do it together as a family for half an hour, not only your life becomes peaceful, you can heal yourself, you can heal the relationship, you can heal the world, but you can also bring peace, you know, to all the elements of matter. And so let us make time for that. As a family, at least for 10-15 minutes, meditate together so that, you know, as they say, together we stand. You know, unity brings strength. And I'm sure if each one of us make up our mind to bring peace by being peace with ourselves, we will be contributing to the world to make this world a better place. So as we know, the situations in the world are changing. So we need to learn methods that could help us to deal from inside out. So when I'm able to look after my feelings, my emotions, my my internal aspects, then I'm able to face the external situation with my inner power. I'm sure this International Day of Yoga will inspire people to look deep within themselves and to have that soul search and connect the soul with the Supreme to draw the power to prepare oneself to face the future with courage. Om Shanti.
Thank you, Sister Meera, for sharing the depth of Raj Yoga, which is a combination of 7 types of yoga that can be practiced in 3 ways, by going on an inward, outward, and upward journey to heal the body and spirit, and also strengthening our inner being by connecting to the Supreme One. Brahma Kumaris are famous for meditational experiences, and who else can be better than Sister Meera, an authority in mind-matter relations, to take us through this journey of managing our thoughts and empowering our spiritual self. Brothers and sisters, please sit back and relax for the meditation commentary by Sister Meera.
Om Shanti. I am sure all of you are already relaxed, having gone through physical, mental, and exercises. We know that silence heals. So maybe it is now time for us to turn within and go into that inner silence. I allow my body to sit comfortably, relax. I breathe in and out, and I feel totally relaxed. As I turn within, I visualize myself as a living light, a shining point of light in the center of my forehead. I become aware. I, the being of light, I am eternal, immortal, imperishable energy. This body is only my instrument. I, the being of light, I am the master of my mind, my intellect, and sanskaras. I can come into the body, or I can go beyond the body at my will. In 1 second, I detach myself from this instrument, my body, and I see myself floating beyond this world of matter. I am moving beyond the cosmos into the dimension of golden red light. I, the being of light, I see myself in this infinite region of golden red light. In this home of silence, I see myself in the presence of the Supreme Light. I come closer and closer, and I touch the light of God. Light upon light in silence. The Supreme Light, like the sun, is radiating beams of light filled with might, which is cleansing I, the soul. I am enjoying being filled with God's light and might. I am getting energized with this God's energy. The Supreme Being, the source of peace, is sending out waves of peace, which is reaching every corner of my being. I have become Master Ocean of Peace. The waves of God's love fills me with the warmth, with love. I enjoy this union with the Almighty, who is energizing the soul, charging my battery with his energy. I stay in yoga. I stay in union with the Supreme Light, allowing I, the soul, to be totally empowered. I am now totally refreshed and recharged. From a distance, I prepare myself as a being of light to return to this field of action, to return to this world of matter, and I see myself returning to this body and shining in the center of my forehead, totally empowered, radiating God's love, God's light, God's peace out into the world. I am totally healed. I am peace. I am light. I am silent. I am balanced. Let me take this gift of peace and silence and share these vibrations out into the world so each soul can enjoy peace, true peace in their life. Om Shanti, Shanti, Shanti.
Brothers and sisters, as we conclude tonight, please ensure to pick up your words of wisdom, what we call God's blessings, that will strengthen you in your times of need. These blessings are beautifully designed by Sister Uma using various asanas. You may pick the asana of your choice and capture the beautiful words associated with it as your special blessing. These blessings will also be made available via a PDF file in the chat for ease of reference at the end of the session. Another link is provided in the chat box for those who are keen to learn Raj Yoga meditation. Ladies and gentlemen, it was our pleasure to host you all this evening. We thank each and every one of you for sparing your valuable time and joining us on this special occasion. Let us continue to build this bond stronger and make this world a better place to live by bringing about the much needed transformation. Good night. Om Shanti. to remain together.